So, hi everyone, this is Renee Forsyth, and we are at Career Cafe at West Campus. It is happening right now until 2 o'clock, and as promised, if you are not able to attend, or if you're just not here yet, we are bringing you what we are calling Cyber Career Cafe. And so I wanted to introduce you to one of our volunteers at the resume tips table, and so that's going to be what we are featuring and bringing to you today. So without further ado, this is... Introduce yourself.
I'm Sharon Macias out of Workforce Development.
Wonderful. And so, resume tips. What are some basic information that you would want a student to know?
The first thing you have to do is decide which kind of resume you want. Is that a functional resume or a chronological resume?
And what's the difference?
Well, a functional will transfer if you have a lot of skills that you want to transfer from one area to another area. That's a great way to do it, is using a functional resume.
Awesome. And we have some examples here that I can show you a quick example of. So, for instance, that chronological resume here, let me get it in the sun. This is what it looks like. So you've got that summary at the top, then you list your experience in reverse chronological order, followed by your education and skills. Whereas opposed, the functional resume is gonna be where, again, you've got your contact information and summary at the top, followed by your education, but then you're highlighting in chunks and bullet points what your skills are. And then at the bottom, very briefly, your work experience. So you're going to want to do that when maybe you're wanting to focus a career change, or when you're doing a career change and you don't have maybe quite as much experience to your name. So Sharon, tell me real briefly, what's this summary statement that I'm talking about? Didn't that used to be an objective?
Well, a summary statement, you really need to be brief and, how do I explain it? Summarize all those skills in one capsule so that the person reading your resume has a very quick idea of what your skill set is.
Okay, awesome. And so if you guys want more information about how to put that stellar summary statement together, you will see that we have another worksheet here for you. If you have questions about how to do it, send me an email or a direct message here on Facebook, or attend the next Career Cafe, and we will hook you up with that. Anything else that you would tell our students about maybe how they can find more information online about resume information or other career services stuff?
Yes, Pima College has lots of resources for you. You can use your My Pima account, and your student resources has a career link full of lots of resources for you. We also have a Pinterest page for Career Cafe, which is just loaded with lots of resources for your resume, interviewing, anything you need that's based on your job search, keeping a job, just tons of resources on either of those pages.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Sharon. So that does it. As you can see, it's really sunny here at the cafe, but it is also still happening. So this is what you would get when you come to Career Cafe. You have all of our different tables and faculty and staff that come and volunteer and give you the tips and information that they have from their own experience that they want to share with you. So again, come and visit us. If you can't make it today by 2 o'clock, we're also doing it at the Desert Vista. And again, if not, that's why we bring you Cyber Career Cafe. Thanks so much. Have a good one. Bye.